J.C. Bach's musical style had a formative influence on Mozart's own, and it was probably Bach, more than anyone, who fired the young Mozart with his love of Italian opera, J.C. Bach's principal stock in trade for many years. When the Mozarts finally returned to Salzburg after their 3.5-year jaunt, they were probably, outside royalty, the most famous family in Europe. And thanks to Leopold's near-ruthless genius as an impresario, they were almost certainly the richest musicians, though Leopold took considerable pains to conceal the fact. Leopold kept his official position at the court, but after an absence of almost 4 years, it was clear that he was more valuable as a travelling musical ambassador than as a court musician. He, or more to the point, his children, had made Salzburg a household name all over Europe. But no one was more keenly aware than Leopold that the children's marketability depended on their youth. After a mere 9 months, therefore, the family hit the road again, this time bound for Vienna, where they stayed for the best part of a year. By the time they got back to Salzburg in January 1769, Mozart, now pushing 13, had put behind him 10 symphonies, 2 operas, 18 sonatas for piano and violin, 3 masses, several other religious choral works, and 4 piano concertos. Well, these last are not strictly speaking his own original compositions, but rather free arrangements and expansions of solo sonatas by various other composers. And they show what a natural feel for the combination of piano and orchestra Mozart seems to have had from the beginning.